So just to illustrate, focused on map rendering, so that's why there is a map, and also marine, so a fast fish, and it has different species, so it was to stay in the same ID. So, if you want to be here, after the talk, I try to summarize and give you some hints and some things. So just to start the context, Java 2D is a great API. It's quite old, but it's great. It performs quite expanded. For the moment, we have two anti-aliasing renderers. What is anti-aliasing renderers? It's mainly to perform the draw and fill operation in shape. It's not about text renderers. And you have so Ductus, which is the closed source renderer. And you also PC since OpenGDK 6. And the status in 2013, Ductus is really fast in a single thread context, but it does not really scale. It means that you have a web server, you are doing rendering in parallel, it's mostly hanging or there is some bottlenecks. PCs is mainly slower because it's a pure Java renderer, but that's not the point. It's mainly a different approach, but it scales better. If you have several threads in parallel, it becomes faster than Ductus. In the context, there is no current GPU solution. The Java 2D pipelines use the GPU to perform some operation like images, pixel blending, and so on. And here also you have JaffaFX, it's an anonymous code, it's a client application, it uses other renderers, it's open PC, it uses also native things. So why the Marlin renderer? It's mainly an OpenGDK PC fork. So I started in 2013, mainly working on client application in my astrophysics laboratory, and I made some profiling of my application with OpenGDK, and I see it was allocating a lot of memory, it was a bit slow. So I started providing patches to improve a bit that, and so I subscribed to the mailing list, I sent some patches, which were amazing, and some interest and feedback. But we decided with Fondra MA, which is in the Java server team, to go on and put this effort on GitHub. So the Marlin renderer and also the mapping projects were available in 2014. OpenGDK, it's a tool to serialize graphics operation, like map rendering, and then you can replay it. So it's very powerful to me, because it helped me to diagnose, to repeat the test, and you will see later. So here are the links to the tools. I have several branches on Marlin renderer. So yeah, you have the pointers. So the objective, be faster, possibly improve the quality, the rendering, the visual quality. And stay compatible with Oracle, OpenGDK, set the 7, 8, 9, any version. It was a very big personal effort. We made several releases in 2014. And as I said, it was test-driven development, so with the regression tool, the map display, which compares the outputs between renderers to stay compatible pixel by pixel. Also, performance, a lot of runs of benchmarks and profiling. Moreover, this release have a small exposure in the GIS community. Mainly the Geo server, Fondra made a lot of benchmarks, and the GBC provides some use case and testing. It was very great in feedback. Here it's a screenshot of GVC, it's a desktop CD application, and here you see it's 100 million points, which are rendered in 3 seconds. It's a large point cloud, and then you can see some tubes in the sea. And so it's parallel rendering. And here it's a final blog post from Andrea in the first Marlin release 0.3. And here you can see that Dictus is in blue, so it's quite fast. But this is a bit slower. But Marlin sometimes at different scales, it's very different. It's another scale in performance. I made a lot of benchmarks, you can see on the wiki page of the project. So next, how to go back into OpenGDK. We signed, both of you, me and Andrea, we signed the Oracle contributor agreement. We stay compatible with the same license, and we have in the end to go back in OpenGDK for everybody. And so we discussed a lot, thanks to last year and Fosdem, we discussed together how to bring it back. And so since March, I've been integrated in the Graphics Pasteurizer project, mainly working with Jim Graham and Phil Race. I work hard because it was not so easy to provide reviews, patches, and going slowly, but certainly. In July, we proposed the JEP 2265 on Marlin Graphics Pasteurizer, which was accepted, automated, and completed in the CD. It's integrated since OpenGDK build 96, and it made also Marlin even faster. I made release also on my GitHub, being in sync between the different code base. But it improved a bit the quality, the coordinate running, and also the large pixel chunk were improved, and we'll see later. So my feedback on contributing to the OpenGDK, it was very interesting. I've learned a lot of things. I discussed with many people, and there are several issues. It's not easy for an outsider, because my company is research, it's public research in France, so totally nothing to do with Java or any of the companies who are here. So, first, the licensing issue, it was not third party code in my contribution, so I have to make something clean up. The web process, it's great, but it's a bit heavy. And for newcomer, you have to learn how to create them, there's a lot of tools. And you have to push them on the OpenGDK servers. You have to get an account. You have to get some credentials and rights. I got a lot of discussion by mail, and it was quite typically more than 1 month per patch. It was a very big patch. It takes a long of time, and the time zone difference is not easy. It has delays and cannot really Skype with people. So let's go faster. Also, there was not a lot of documentation, and there was no continuous integration, easily accessible for outsiders. And let's go faster. So how works Java2D? Three words. You have the SunGraphics2D, which delegates to the hash-shaped pipe to render the path. It has to compute the coverage mask, and then you have the mask field operation in software like C-Crowd or OpenGL, which blends the pixel on the screen or on the image. Marlin, really quickly, it's like pieces. You have to provide the coverage mask, so you have several steps. You have a pipeline with the dasher, the stroker, the renderer. Forward, typically it's a quite well-known active HTML algorithm. Yeah, it's quite tricky because you don't have pointers in Java, but you can do some integer-based pointer. You have some integer, the integer serves like a pointer in an array, and then you have some structs, and it's really close to value types, something like that. Every data is not allocated in the heap, it's all flattened in arrays. just an illustration. So Marlene, performance optimization is mainly to avoid the GC allocation. In Marlene, you don't need it at all because I use a small context which is kept in memory attached using web or soft reference, kept in thread local, and so you always reuse the same small shape of memory, which is quite optimized. And it's more like C programming, you use only dirty parts to be as fast as possible. It's really tricky, but I've added a lot of checks and things inside Marlin so I can ensure it's correct and efficient. I use also save some different optimization and profiling tools and also my metrics and internal checks. The MapBench benchmark is just because I will give you some plots, just to say to reduce the variability, I have to disable inverse threading, I have to use fixed frequency to ensure the scalability, and always have the same initial conditions. So before Marlin, in blue you have Ductus, in red you have PCs. So you can see that typically Ductus is a lot faster than PCs, but when you have four threads, one, two, four threads, PC becomes faster. And then here is Marlin. You don't see it, it's normal. It's always here. Yeah, it's a very complex map. And so it's really fast. Here you have the ratio. 100% it's Marlin. So you see the others are smaller. And then it's just a small issue with volatile image. If I use buffered image, totally perfect. If I use volatile image, you see the same effect. At one thread, sometimes it's faster, sometimes no. But you see there is also a bottleneck with volatile images. Volatile images, it's images who are staying in the GPU memory and you can use a faster blending using the OpenGL and things like that. So how to use Marlin, just a few points here. You have to add, if you download Marlin on my GitHub, you have to add this line. If you use OpenGDK name, now it's really easy. It works also in Jigsaw. And here is the demo. So let's start it. So the demo is really straightforward. It's the same tool I've made, so it replaces some stylized worries and central map. And you see here it's PC, typically 20 frames on this thing. It uses four threads in parallel, four different images which are regularly painted. So you see that it's not stuck, so quite slow, it depends on the size. Maybe I'm late, so I will go. Yes. So you see the almost speed. So there is just an illustration with maps. So there is a step where it calibrates, and then it renders one thread, then two threads, then four. That's why you see the thing. And I just made a rotation because it's just to see it visually. So here the map is almost 6 frames per second. And then with Marlin, so it can brace. And then you see that as it's Java, you see the code is compiling and optimizing and going a bit faster. So. And then you have 16 frames per second on this line. It's going very fast. And here, as the image is smaller, you have less pixels to blend, so it goes even faster. And so, Ductus, I want to show it, because it's really interesting. Yeah, it's the frame per second I've made with what I showed you. So, Ductus is quite fast. Marlin, where it is. Yes, Marlin is in here, the HPC, and it depends. When you add threads, it goes faster. Now, has several tuning parameters. Typically, you can adjust the number of the sub-pixels, so if you want to go faster, you can simplify the quality, or you can increase it. You can also adjust a bit the tile size. It could be interesting for different pipelines on the X-Renderer or things like that. And also, you can enable rock statistics. Here is a summary of a few new settings. And also, I would like to do some work as the cut freeze of the Unique line is not reached. I would expect to do some new improvements. And of course, I would be very pleased to get some feedbacks. And please try it with your use case or your context. You can try parallel rendering. And if you would like, I would be enjoyed if you could help me or contribute to perform new algorithm. Some quality IDs. For me, the most important one is the gamma correction. You have gamma correction on the text rendering, but on shapes, it's not the case. And it's really, really important. It's mainly done in C macro in the quantity case, and I'm not really good at that. But I could try to, I've done it in Java, but it's not a good idea. And then also the algorithm should be improved. We use some analytical pixel coverage to be more accurate in the path. It's mainly the two ideas, and it's on the performance. There is no clipping algorithm, and even it's not so straightforward to do. And also, we could improve the cap and jump processing, simplify a bit the segments and the preliminarity and things like that. But for me, the two main important things is the gamma correction and the more accurate algorithm to compute the coverage of the pixel. It's a bit illustrated, but you can use typically the area, the trapezoid area, instead of the counting sub-pixels. So that's all, folks. Thank you for your attention. I think I've presented a sort of an overview. If you have questions, contact me after a question. Really happy to discuss with you.
How far do you think you can go? How much faster? Do you think there's some value types in 10
nanometers? Yes. Yes, volume types could be helpful, because we did it manually here, but I think it can be improved. And safe is a bit helpful also to avoid bone checks, but very touch could be faster. But it's software rendering, so it's not comparable to a GPU-based solution. Every types, yes, it could simplify the code, and maybe avoid bone checks. Because there is a lot of loops, a lot of tricks in the code. It's quite good. Yes, please.
Any plans to create this as a principle in
documents? I should be discuss that. I know that OpenPC is in JavaFX. Maybe we could try to. It is, I think, the PC's code has been ported to C. So the same approach could be done. It's a bit different because the scoper or the property of the render are a bit different. It has been, should be adjusted, but it could be imported, of course. It's a matter of manpower. Because I spent a lot of evenings, time, and home, evenings, and so that's why I really liked to get some developers involved, or to have people or anybody who is interested. I have a question. Yes, I did not mention, for the moment it's the different engine in both NGDK and EcoGDK. I think J1 proposed that in order to make mine the maximum exposure, and I hope it will stay the case. But in case there was an issue, I cannot guarantee that we will stay in the EcoGDK. I would be very pleased if that is the case. Oh, thank you.